beautiful structures in Midtown is that Skybridge. That's where that Skybridge goes if Hochul and Vornado get their way. It goes in the dumpster. This building, which is still Hotel Penn, by the way, because that's how big it is, and the building next door, which was trivia, anybody know, it's not the Manhattan Mall when it started its life.
Gimbel.
It was Gimbel. Gimbel opened 3 weeks before Pennsylvania Station did in 1910. Here's a really fun fact. Everybody thinks that Gimbel actually bought the land from the Pennsylvania Railroad. They did not. You know who they bought it from? They bought it from the H&M, not the clothing store. They bought it from the Hudson and Manhattan Railway. That's why the PAP station is still in the basement today. The Hudson and Manhattan sold Gimbel this land for them to put their New York flagship store. In 1923, they went public. Who partnered with them? Anybody know? Saks, of Saks Fifth Avenue. And they opened up a conglomeration with that building, the building across the street, and called it Saks 34th Street. In an attempt to give their shoppers a beautiful and comfortable experience, they brought in two guys by the name of Shreve and Lamb to design a proto Art Deco three-story skybridge so that you could walk back and forth between Saks and Gimbel's and be protected. Three-story copper. Anybody know what Shreve and Lamb went on to design? They're big names, check it out. The Empire State Building.
Wow.
So they went on to actually build the Empire State Building. A gorgeous, gorgeous example of architecture. Is it landmark?
No.
Is it protected by anybody?
No.
Is there public access? Absolutely not, unfortunately.
Wow.
Now, picture a world where we live. In pretty good conditions. Open that up to the public. It would be amazing. But instead, what are we going to do? We're going to bulldoze it and replace it with super tall glass. Do you want this?
No!
Right?
That is such history loss.
Again, Penn for all. This Penn district is bullshit. I'm sorry. Let's make it a neighborhood. Let's make it for the people who live here. Let's make it for New York. It's a gateway. This is where the whole country comes into New York. Why would we want to do this?
Right.
This is worth fighting for.
And it's in the new West Side Story movie.
Say again?
It's in the new West Side Story movie.
And it is in the new West Side Story. Because it's the last. New York had many skybridges, by the way, and they've all been systematically taken down. This is one of the last skybridges left, and it's one of the best in America. Let's not lose it. So, you've been given sheets. What can you do? You can reach out to the people on this sheet. You can submit comments by February 22nd and say, you don't want to lose architectural treasures. Reuse them. People will come back to them. This building, by the way, 1011? Fine. Not being touched. Also a 1912 Beaux-Arts marble. The only building Vornado is leaving alone.
We know why.
I think because it is fully occupied and Vornado is leaving it as of, well, we're going to give you this. But it's fine.
Is it residential?
No, it's business.
So if you check the occupancy rates on this building, it's about, I think, 88%. It's one of the highest in Vornado's whole repertoire in this area. Why? Because it's a beautiful building right now. You have more of them you could do. All right, so we're going to go to the hotel.
Can I just say something?
Yes.
So I want to point out, see the building over there with the lights at the thing? So I used to actually manage a data center on the top floor of that building. And they recently said, hey, there's a view here. And they revamped, I mean, I know it's like a mid-60s office building, but they took it and they turned it into like a swanky restaurant. The 39th floor of that building is now a swanky restaurant.
Because of the view of this.
Because of the view.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah. And they're doing the same, they were going to do the same thing at 2 Penn.
It is unique, it is beautiful, it is worth reverence. It is not worth getting rid of. I can't say that enough. It actually bothers me to think that somebody would even think that's a good idea.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. All right.
Okay, where are we going?
We're